Hello, good people. I'm Jason with Squad Car 37, and you are watching Micro Tutorial Tuesday, where I put a minute and 37 seconds on the clock and share with you a music tip or life lesson. In this episode, we're going to explore an element that is absolutely critical to creating a great sounding song. But first, I'm gonna do some laundry. One of the most effective ways to create drama and interest in your song is to use...
Hey, this is a commercial. Hey, be sure to dislike this video and add negative comments below. This commercial is now over.
Dynamics. Let's put a minute and 37 seconds on the clock and get started. Here are some dynamic elements that can really accentuate your song's arrangement and mix. Complexity, frequency, volume, and width. With regard to complexity, I'd recommend having a mix of simple sections of your song and more complex sections of your song. By simple, I mean less things going on, less instrumentation, less notes. And complex, meaning more things going on, more things of interest, more instrumentation, more layers, etc. So your first verse might want to be...
Hey, this is a commercial. Be sure to dislike this video and add negative comments below. This commercial is now over.
Be less complex than your second verse, because the second verse is going to give you more new things to listen to. Now let's talk frequency. During the chorus or the hook of your song, you might want to have a wide spread of frequencies hitting your ears, from low, super low sounds to mid-range and high sounds. Now in the very beginning of the song, maybe in the intro, you just want to provide just a little bit of those frequencies, so maybe just some mid-range stuff. And in the verse, you open up and you give a little bit more of the lows and a little bit more of the highs. And by the time you get to the chorus, you can open it up to provide a full frequency spectrum. That way your ears will hear a difference between the verse and the chorus, and the chorus will have a bigger payoff. Volume. Think about orchestras. They do such a good job of getting very quiet in certain parts and then getting really loud in other parts, and it creates that drama. It pulls you along through the song. So use volume in your song to create that continued interest from start to finish. Finally, width. Width has to do with panning and stereo spread.
Hey, this is a commercial. Be sure to dislike this video and add negative comments below. This commercial is now over.
So if you're listening to something in mono, that means the sound is coming directly at you right here in the center. Now when you start adding stereo components, things in your ears sound much wider. So during choruses, you might want to have a really wide sound, a big stereo sound, and during the verses, you want to have more of the instrumentation closer to the center. So when it gets to the chorus, it sounds bigger and wider and better, more pleasing. Or you could do the opposite. The point is, experiment with contrasting the mono sound and the stereo sound, or the width of your song, to create drama and interest. Thanks for watching Micro Tutorial Tuesday. I hope this was helpful.
Hey, this is a commercial. Be sure to dislike this video and add negative comments below. This commercial is now over.
Don't forget to like and subscribe, ring-a-ding the bell, and we'll see you in the next video.